How are you?
Welcome again. I hope today will be a wonderful session. Did you pay your consultation?
Yeah, this time I paid as soon as I got in.
Good.
And hope everything will go better today.
Wonderful.
This time my problem, I have three problems. Like I said, the first time I came when I had three people, I decided to go with one. But he has problems. I don't know why he doesn't put the toilet seat down.
Why?
The one I got married to.
Which toilet seat?
The toilet seat, as in the flushing toilet. He never puts the toilet seat down. You know how it hurts
you.
It's annoying. You come from, you want to sit, you wake up early in the middle of the night, you want to go, and you sit on something very cold.
Ew.
Do you know how it feels? Now I'm almost getting a heart attack. In fact, cardiac arrest.
Candida what?
Cardiac arrest.
Cardiac for the heart?
No! Yes, that one, for the heart. Second, as soon as he enters the house, he starts undressing. Shirt off, tie off, coat off, throwing clothes. As in, I can't...
So he strips the moment he enters
the house. This is not stripping when you come picking the clothes from behind. It's as if I'm dealing with a baby. This is a grown-up man.
Are you sure he's dropping them for you to pick them? Or dropping them for him to the bedroom?
Not dropping them for me to pick them. I'm not a maid. For heaven's sake, I'm his wife.
Okay.
And then he doesn't know I ever specify that socks are in the middle drawer. For God, listen to me. The socks are in the middle drawer, not the left drawer, not the... But the... And he walks me up and says, honey, where are my socks?
So, where are the socks?
In the middle drawer. And you can't find them.
So when they're in the middle drawer, you're the only one who knows they're there.
And I also keep telling him they're in the middle drawer.
But you, where do you get them from before you put them
I
in the middle
I pick them around when he throws them around. I'm tired.
Do you know, I'm wondering what your problem is up to now, since you started talking. Because if he leaves the socks throwing them around, what you don't understand is that men are hunters. Men love the chase. Eh? So when he comes home and throws the things around, after you have washed the socks, throw them around, like how, you know how you plant in the garden? Yeah. Throw them around.
Scatter.
So that when he comes home, he wakes up in the morning with something to look forward to. Will I find my socks here? Will I not? Maybe, if I get the blue one, will I find the green one? You're making his life very boring. Put intrigue in your marriage. Eh? If he's throwing them around, throw them around. Don't put them in the drawer. Because he wants them where he left them.
Feeling a hunter.
Feeling a hunter. About the toilet, did you know, statistically, when we look at the statistics of families that are married for the longest time in monogamous marriages in Africa, we have seen that 76% of those marriages don't have flushing toilets, they use pit latrines. I don't know whether that clicks in your head.
Yes, they use
pit latrines. Hence, no flushing toilet, no marital problem. Or you can... No toilet seat. You can go to a pit latrine and you will be shocked when there is no seat open. And you can be very comfortable.
Doctor, come to think of it. Suppose I have a latrine.
In the same house?
Outside. I have a latrine. And I haven't been stressing myself. Why don't I use
I'm
the latrine?
I'm not going to doctor for nothing.
And use the toilet for him. I won't care if the toilet seat is up or down. I'll be using that. You know, I feel like John speak right now. I've discovered Lake Victoria for the second time. Doctor! Thank you!
You are welcome. Oh. Anytime.
Flattering.
Anytime.
I've given up on what? Toilet seats.
Something is not right. So she could have taken the toilet and given the man the pitra tree. Who knows what she prefers?
Oh dear, how are you?
Good. Yeah? How is the village? How is the town into the village? You see, being in the village, I think everyone
you
was,
you
in
got
the
locked
village.
Here.
My head is locked in the village, but isn't God good? And my life is going to change drastically. At least for 2 weeks, people are going to know I have traces of the city. I started with rice. You know, we don't eat rice these days in the village.
Oh.
It's very hard. You know, the weather is bad.
I know.
So I bought this kilo of rice, but when my husband knows I've cooked rice, he even comes to the kitchen to help me serve. He So the only time I get to eat it is when I am actually sorting it and I keep throwing a few seeds in my mouth.
What is still wrong?
I'm telling you, survival for the wisest. I'm telling you, eh? Surprise me. Tell me.
Town is good. Tell me, I'm town. Telling you.
People are going to know. Eh. For once, at least I'm going to have 2 weeks of shiny teeth, smooth skin, and I will be in the network socializing. Tweet kwa WhatsApp. They are going to get. They are going to feel it.
Actually,
thank you so much. And I like it. Eva, you never come empty-handed.
Of course.
That's
I
why
cannot.
When you say you are coming, I organize myself and prepare. Surprise me, please.
I cannot.
Of course.
When I'm there, I think about you.
Me.
I think what should I take for this woman?
Okay.
What should
wait.
I take?
Okay.
The village is okay. I can see, but the weather. It is hot. Eh?
Okay.
And over here, this bag is full of avocado.
So now, hold on. I think the things I'm most interested in right now are the ones which are there. You know, now let me tell you. For us, the visitors, when you hear someone is coming from Kampala, first of all, the first thing you do is clear all the sockets in the village. Open, because I heard there's now Manya, every phone, there's Galaxy,
heavy.
This one, there's you what, this one, I this one.
Now, in here, there is kedo, avocado.
Avocado, the fruit, or now that we have apple laptop, they might have made avocado laptop.
Avocado, the fruit, the green fruit.
I'm
but
really
it's delicious, my
Eva,
friend.
Eva, calm
like
down,
it.
Calm down. Of course, I am the avocado specialist. I have a tree. You passed it when you were coming. At the gate, we have an avocado tree, just in case you didn't know. And you passed in the backyard. And unless you go to these things from my garden, there's nothing you have brought for me that is not in the garden. So if you're playing a prank, you better unpray it because it's stopping to be fun. Is this what you brought for me from the city?
From the bottom of my heart, yes.
No, I've not asked which body organ has produced these things. Is this what you brought for me from the city?
Yes, can't see.
Do you stay in the city, Eva? Oh, they chased you from your marriage and you've been staying in the backyard, just here in the village, and you've been lying to people. You come from the city. Because what's this? Every time, everyone who has a visitor that comes from a city or gifts that come from the city, they have to be chargeable. It's got to either be a phone or a laptop or a solar panel, something that needs electricity. And for me, okay. When they give them things from the city, they go around town frosting, showing them off. What am I supposed to do exactly? Carry a maize in my armpit and accidentally drop it and say that's coming from the city. That's what I'm going to do. I'm expecting to be walking around taking selfies of the garden and the goats that I'm raising. And you're bringing me things that have... You wasted your time. Let me tell you.
You've not appreciated.
No, thank you, but no thank you. Next time, call me. Let me be a part of your visit. Next, don't come here intending to surprise me only for you to give me the worst introduction ever. You've come with, what's this? No, help me understand. Okay. I'm sorry I'm rude.
Yes,
help me understand it. I'm
are.
Sorry. Explain it. Explain exactly why you got this. Because I know you rent in a small house. Eh? You're in some quarters in town. So where did you dig these ones? Exactly where.
That's what I thought that would make you happy.
Then you want to go back to town, fill your car with a boot full of Irish potatoes, from the village, sucks, and then you go around when they ask you, how was the village? Oh, stressing. People in the village asking for that, asking for this. So carry your things back to town so that you do not. Go back to town, organize yourself, plan, say I might go to visit, can't see me at this point, let me save enough money, maybe let me, if you are not going to bring me any, prepare yourself. Clearly, this visit.
Can't do that, I take it back.
If there's any villager who will accept these gifts when you're coming from the city, bring them with me. If they can allow, use my neighbor, ask. If you're going to give these gifts to someone who is in the village, what are you trying to poke? So I am Roko. You want me to dig a grave and now be just botanical and become like a Kuropa and also grow. So me being Roko and in the village is not bad enough. You've come to show me that this is where I belong. No development. And identify. Help me understand. That scarf you have in your neck, if you gave it to me, what would happen? Eh? You have that bag you're putting in avocados. If you gave it to me, what would you lose? Eh? What would you lose? You're wearing Brazilian hair, putting a headscarf. You think because I like it? So pack your things. Organize yourself. If you want to come and visit me, ask me what I will want. Trust me. I'll even hire traditional dancers who shall get up and dance for you because you have come to visit us. Till then, please carry your things and go.
Please.
And my dear, and you found me going to cook rice. How I feed you rice? My rice, my special delicacy, rice. and you intend to sleep here, and you're living pineapple, sugarcane, banana, maize. Congratulations. You get the same road that brought you. Next time when you're coming to visit, organize, plan. Plan, please.
This is not fair.
Hey, honestly, as if it's fair for you to come and eat the little good things. You didn't even buy soda. Did I tell you I'm allergic to yogurt? I've had there's what? Frankfurters. Eat meat. Am I allergic to those things? Only for you to bring me the same stuff I have in the garden. Oh, feel free. Pass by the garden and add yourself. Take more to town. Say they gave me.
Kasima, you're a bad friend. I'm telling you.
Kasima, you are good. And that bag is too light. It must have just two avocados. I've come to visit you. So what am I going to do? Walk around the town where carrying that bunch of matoke? Others walk around with iTabs taking pictures. Can banana take pictures?
Just don't mess with Kansime.